Hello everyone. So today I am going to explain you about simple air cooling system. What happens in simple air cooling system? First of all, we have some main components in this system, and this part is known as main compressor. This part is called gas turbine. This part is the combustion chamber. This part is the cooling turbine. This is the cooling fan. And this part is called the heat exchanger. Now, to explain this simple air cooling system, generally in aircraft it is used generally in aircraft refrigeration system. Now, what happens? Suppose this is our aeroplane and it is moving in this direction. Now, if this aeroplane is moving in this direction, then there is, suppose the velocity of this aeroplane moving in forward direction is V. Now there is air which opposes this aircraft motion. Now the velocity of the air is also the same as the velocity of the movement of this aircraft. So what happens? The velocity of air also tries to reduce or tries to friction this movement by an equal opposite velocity air. Now the air also have the same velocity as the velocity of aircraft. So we utilize this speed and this velocity of the air for the cooling system in aircrafts or in planes. Now what happens? We design the body of the aircraft in such a manner that suppose this is high velocity V, some velocity V, which this velocity V comes from this portion. This is aeroplane and it is moving in this forward direction with some velocity V which is very high. Now this same velocity V of air is present there to oppose this motion, and we utilize this air for the refrigeration system in aeroplanes. What happens? This velocity, when it is made to enter inside, this portion is used to run the turbine and this compressor, which is used for the suction, and this portion is used for the cooling phenomena inside the refrigeration. What happens when this velocity enter inside this chamber? This air which is entering is called ram air, and the air present in the atmosphere, this air is called ambient air. Now when this ambient air enters in this portion, this ram air is made to fed, or it is made to input inside this compressor. Now what happens when this ram air travels this portion? Due to friction, here friction will occur, and due to this friction it raises some of its pressure and temperature. Now at this portion it has some P and some temperature. Suppose P and T are the pressure and temperature at this point. Now when this air is made to enter inside the compressor, what this compressor do? It increases the pressure and temperature of this air. Now this high pressure and high temperature gas is made or is fed inside the combustion chamber, where combustion of this air fuel takes place, and this high pressurized, the temperature also rises in this combustion chamber, and this high pressurized high temperature gas or this air is used to run the turbine, which the shaft connection of this turbine is used to run this compressor again. So what happens? We utilize the air, which the high pressurized and high temperized air, we utilize this air for the further refrigeration process. For the refrigeration process, this portion is not required as much as this is required, though we are getting, or the air which is used we are taking from this portion only, but main refrigeration phenomena takes place in this portion. What happens, this high pressure and high temperature air which is present this portion, we bled some of the air. What we do, we take out some of the air and made it to fed inside the heat exchanger. What happens when this high pressure and high temperature air enters in this heat exchanger, what we do, we make passage for the ram air. This is the ram air, and what we do, we make passage for ram air to enter, and the hot air, the highly pressurized and temperature air flows in this pipe, and the ram air, which is of the temperature and pressure of the ram air, is less than the temperature and pressure of the air which is flowing inside this tube. So what happens, heat exchange phenomena takes place, and as this air is having large temperature than the air which is present in this portion, so this air get cools. So the hot air which is earlier present in this pipe, now it get cools while passing through heat exchanger, and further we fed this air inside the cooling turbine. What happens, suppose we are unable to get the temperature which is required in this portion. Suppose this is the aeroplane cabin and we want to maintain some temperature K, but till this portion we are unable to get this K temperature, then what we do, we apply an apparatus called cooling turbine. Now this cooling turbine, what it do, it raises the temperature, or it maintains the K temperature which is required to be sent in the cabin. So the cool temperature is made to fed inside this cooling turbine. Here the required temperature or the desired temperature is obtained, and then this desired temperature is fed inside the cabin of the aeroplane. Now this temperature, or this the hot temperature which comes out from this portion, this is the cool temperature or the cool air which is fed inside the cabin. Now the air, hot air which exchanges the heat, it is made to pass through this passage and it is sent to the atmosphere through this cooling fan to the atmosphere through the help of this cooling fan. So what happens, what we do, we collect mg plus mc amount of heat. This mg heat is for the combustion process, and mc heat is for this mg and mc air, not heat, sorry, this mg and mc air from this portion. This mg portion, this mass, mg is for mass, so mg is mass of air to be sent in chamber, that is combustion chamber, and mc is the mass of air to be sent in cooling chamber. This is a cooling portion, cooling chamber. So at this portion we collect mg plus mc amount of air. Now this mg portion of the air is sent inside this combustion chamber, and this heats up and it raises the temperature of this air and is used to run the gas turbine. Now this turbine runs, this main compressor, and the sucking process of air takes place in this portion. Now this MC portion of the air is fed from this portion and it is sent to the heat exchanger, where exchange of heat takes place and this air gets cools down, and this cool air is sent to the cooling turbine, where the temperature further decreases to the temperature which is desired to be maintained inside the cabin of the aeroplane. So this, when this temperature is reached, it is sent to the cabin of the aeroplane, and the hot air which is exchanged, or which takes up the heat of this air, it is made to send in the atmosphere through this cooling fan. So this principle, this general working principle, is used inside a simple air cooling system. It is generally used for ground surface or low velocity aircrafts, generally which carry passenger to maintain the cabin temperature or to provide the refrigerating effect in hot days. So the main components are the main compressor, the heat exchanger, the cooling turbine or the cooling system. The air required for the cooling is bled off from the main compressor, and high temperature and high pressure, the air passes through the heat exchanger. It cools down due to presence of ram air. This ram air is made to enter here and it cools down the hot air in the heat exchanger. Now air passes through cooling turbine where air is expanded. This at this portion the air is expanded up to the desirable condition and the pressure and temperature is maintained in this cooling turbine. So according to the use or the desired temperature, this air is maintained and sent into the cabin. So this is the working of simple air cooling system. Thank you.